Now, as we begin with Chapter 1, as I mentioned before, this chapter is very, very significant on the test. Really, the two pieces that we have here, risk management and business continuity. All decisions start with risk management, and everything we do supports the continuity of the business. So this is a very, very big chapter. Make sure you take lots of notes and pay attention. All right, so moving in, we're going to talk about some things. We're really going to set the groundwork for a lot of the material that we're going to cover in greater depth as we move forward. So one of the first things that we'll talk about, just the basics of security, the security triad, confidentiality, integrity, and availability. And a lot of times, you'll hear that referred to as the CIA triad. Now, there's actually a movement to call it the AIC triad because they're afraid that we will confuse the CIA, the agency, with the CIA triad of confidentiality, integrity, and availability. I'm going to just trust that you guys can keep that separate in your mind and know that I will not talk about the Central Intelligence Agency in this class at all. So I'm a creature of habit. I learned it as the CIA triad. That's what I'll continue to use. But if you are using other courseware, if you're using some of the other books out there as prep, you may hear them refer to it as the AIC triad. All right, next we'll talk about the IAAA. So we'll talk about identification, authentication, authorization, and auditing or accounting, because auditing is all about accountability. But those are that's basically the IAAA of access control. So we're going to get some of these security terms out there and we're going to talk about and define them. Then we're going to cover the difference between governance and management. And a lot of times you'll hear those words interchangeably. So it's very important to understand the role that governance plays in the organization, the role that management does. Then we'll move into talking about some legal issues. We'll talk about compliance. We'll talk about regulatory issues, and then we'll look at professional ethics as well. As a matter of fact, the ISC Square Code of Ethics is very much testable on this exam, and by the time you take this exam, you will have signed it, so you might as well read it. Security policy, standards, procedures, and guidelines. Once we've done our risk analysis and once we've understood the value of what we're protecting, the potential for loss, the impact of that loss, well, at that point forward, we then develop our policies and procedures so that we can operate within the acceptable level of risk. So policies and procedures, standards, guidelines come in. And then last but not least, business continuity and disaster recovery. Big, big, big. All of the things that we do to make sure that our organization continues to move forward even in the event of a disaster, whether that disaster is fire, flood, hurricane, tremendous loss of data, security breach, and it really determines, it really depends on the business what our disasters are. Being able to move forward and continue operations even in the event of a disaster is very, very important.